Hi, in this video we are going to learn about round function. Round function does nothing but it rounds up a specific number to the given number of decimal places. Here we will learn four types of round functions basically. One is the default round function, then we'll look at the round up, round down and the m round function. If you want to follow along with me, then please do download the data which is given below in the description link and let's get started.
Hello everyone. The topic for today is round. So round is a very crucial function of Excel. So as you can see, there are four sheets which are available on this Excel: round up, round down, round and m round. So there are four types of round which are primarily used. So we'll be going one by one and checking out each of the formulas for that. So let's start with the first one, which is round up. Okay, now what is round up? Round up, basically it will round up, as it says, to the nearest value, up to the nearest value. So I do a equal to, you have two values here, 157.2 and 60.7. I will do a round up. Round is a number up away from zero. So bracket open, the first syntax is number and the second syntax is the digit. So I will put the number, which is 157.2, and I will keep a digit at, so how many decimals do I want? Number of digits meaning how many decimals. I put a 0 at first. Now let's see what comes. It rounds to 158, which is basically the next number after 157. So what if I put 1? If I put 1, it will automatically take the value which is there because it has already one decimal. But what if I put a decimal over here, which is 5? It will still take 0.3 because it is rounding up to the next value. That's why 157.25 comes to 157.3. If I change 1 again to 2, it will be 157.25. So what it does is, so this is the decimal part and this is the number. I will keep it at 0 now, which takes it to the next value. So 157.25 rounds up to 158. Now let's take the next value. Again, I'll do a round up. Again, as there is one decimal, I'll just put a 0, which should come as 61 because it's rounding up. So round up, always remember, rounds up to the value of decimal that you want. It always goes up, it never comes down. So always remember that round up always goes up and rounds it to the next level, decimal or integer. Now moving on to the next part, which is round down. Round down, again, as the name suggests, it rounds down. It never goes up, it rounds down. So again, equal to round down, number and what decimal? Let's put 0 at first. It is 157 because it's rounding down. You remember round up went to 158. So 157, it goes down. Now let's check for 60.7. It should come to 60 because we are rounding down. Though the decimal is greater than 5.5, it is still going down. So that is the whole logic of round up and round down. Now crucially, moving to another part, which is round. Round is actually the overall part of round up and round down. Round up only takes up and round down only takes down. Round actually looks at the decimal and sees if it's 0.5 above or below. Now let's see, I will do a round. Okay, so this is below 0.5, that's why it should take 65 because it's below 0.5. So 0.2 is below 0.5. Again, same, the number and the number of decimals. I'll keep 0, 65 because this is less than 0.5. That's why it's coming as 65. Again, round. So now there are three decimals over here, 100.567. Now first I keep it at 0. It will take 101 because it is greater than 567. Now if I change this to, now let's see what happens. I will take one decimal, it will round to 100.5 because 0.02 is less than 0.005, which is the second decimal. Again, if I change this value to say 6, this should take 100.6 because 0.006 is greater than 0.05. That's why 100.6. So that is the whole meaning of this entire round up function. Now, what if you want to do a negative value? So negative value also, you can change, it takes to the value which is there. It sums to the value which is there. Hence, if you want to put an absolute in front of this or a minus sign, it will be a positive. So that is the whole function of round over here. First the value, then the number of digits. Now the last part, which is mRound, which is a new function. So round down and round, all related to your decimals. Nothing more than that. But mRound is related to something else. It basically divides your factor. Now let's see. So let's take one example. So mRound, okay, this is the value. What is the multiple? Say I put multiple of 2 first. What is the nearest multiple of 2 in 14? That is 14 itself. So 14 is a multiple of 2, even number. That's why the nearest multiple is 14 itself. If I put a 3 here, then the nearest multiple of 3 in 4, by 14 is 15. So 15 is the nearest to 14. That's why that comes. If I put a 4, so 16 is the nearest. Obviously, 12 is also there. 16 is there. It has taken 16. So 16 is the nearest multiple of 4, which is closer to 14. So that is the meaning of mRound. So if I, now let's say, I put 2 here. I put, again, just copy paste the formula below. Put 3 here and put 4 here. If you see, so 3 is closest multiple is 15, 4 is closest multiple is 16, 2 is closest multiple is 14 itself. If I put, say, any value here, 7, again 14, because 7, 14 is a multiple of 7. If I put a 9, then 18, because 18 is the closest to 14. So that is about the entire round function and how it is very useful. And these are the ways you basically use round up, round down, round and mRound wholly in Excel.
I hope you found this video to be useful. Please do like, comment and share this with others too. We do come up with lots of finance and Excel videos almost on a daily basis. And if you haven't subscribed to our channel yet, please do subscribe so that you get the notification as soon as we release a new one. So thank you so much for watching. Goodbye.